Intoxicating smell of the graveyard. Once a year, we gather beneath our family tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come, every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided, and let us celebrate what it is to be an Addams. Come to me, my luscious wife. Oh, she of skin so pale, eyes so black, and dress cut down to Venezuela. And tell us what it is every Addams hopes for.
Darkness, grief, and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk sexy. When you're an Addams, you need to have a little moonlight. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. Have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way when you're an Addams.
You need to have a sense of humor.
When you're an Addams, you need to have a taste for death.
Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Addams, you do what Addams always do.
Mi amor.
Will you love me forever and ever?
We shall be as besotted with each other as the night we met.
Our first date, you took me to see.
Death of a Salesman.
How we laughed.
When you're an Addams,
you gotta have a lot of passion.
When you're an Addams,
you need to really love your wife
several times a day.
You're happy when your toes are in the mud. You smile a bit the moment you smell blood. When you're an Addams,
you need to grab a bow and arrow.
When you're an Addams,
you need a moment to explode. Just pour the potion,
flip the switch,
and
when you're an Addams, you have to really stir the pot. So give us shadows and give us gloom. Broken glass in a motel room. Something fun we can all exhume and give it all tonight.
And on this night, beneath our family tree, we summon our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because living or dead, family is still family.
Yes, and how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, dance, my brother Fester. Time to wake the dead. Bonnie Hop! the tweeds. Rigor mortis. Death rattle.
When you're an Addams,
right, when
you
you're
have a very
Addams,
special duty.
Night out with the Addams.
When you're an Addams,
one bite,
you're obligated to the fam. It's family first and family last, and family by and by. When you're an Addams, the standard interest don't apply. When you're an Addams, you do what Addams do or
next year, my beloved ancestors, back to your crypt.
Hey, it's locked.
That's right. We have a problem.
His name is Lucas. Lucas Beinecke, and I'm in love.
That's right. Little Wednesday Addams. That charming, irrepressible bundle of malice who would poison her own brother just for a ride in the ambulance has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little white cottage with a picket fence and an apple tree.
I like the part about being locked up.
Okay, so here's the deal. Gather around. I'm not letting any of you back into that crypt until love triumphs.
But faster.
Ah. So, who is this Lucas fella? Is he worthy of her? Do they really love each other? What is love anyway? Does this rash look serious to you? So many questions about love. But when you think about it, is there really anything more important? Let's not talk about anything else but love. Aww. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else. Fight, sir, fight like a man. Feel the kiss of my Spanish steel. Ha, 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 ha. Foiled again. Oh. Damn your lightning reflexes.
Gomez, look.
Oh, flowers. Who would send something so tasteless?
The most precious gift there is, more goody-licious than gold, is that blessing we call friendship, whether new or very old.
Goody-licious? Who talks like this?
The Beinekes. Wednesday's friend Lucas and his parents. They're coming for dinner tonight.
Lucas?
Yes.
But Lucas is a boy's name.
Yes.
Wednesday has a friend who's a boy?
It's nothing, darling. Puppy love. Put these in water. Mom, Dad, I shot dinner. Oh, Wednesday, That's lovely. Wherever did you find it?
Petting zoo.
Thank you, dear. Come, Lurch. We'll whip up something real special. And this time, we'll actually cook it. Oh, Gomez, guests for dinner. Fresh meat.
Daddy, I have something very important to tell you.
What is it?
Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Look.
Well, if I didn't know any better, I'd say that looked like an engagement ring. What are you saying?
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beinecke loves me and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes, I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never met his parents and he's never met mine and I just need to be sure.
That he's the one.
That the families can get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What are you saying?
I'm saying we're who we are, and they're from Ohio.
Ohio? A swing state?
That's what I mean.
You're right. This is important. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
No? But we have to tell your mother.
Daddy, please. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want to tell your mother that you're getting married.
After dinner, and we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But...
Daddy, please.
But...
If you love me...
But...
Do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife. Say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do? Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
One tiny little secret, Daddy, please. Please?
Okay, okay.
Thank you. Our little secret, right?
Yes, yes, our little secret. Wednesday's throwing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's throwing up as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else to make her father wonder why, oh why? Wednesday's growing up. She'll be Thursday before you know it. A puzzling thing. A secret in the house. A boy, a girl, a ring.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
Oh, what is it?
She's in the kitchen, smiling. Like this. Maybe it's this boy.
This boy. Don't be silly. Ha, I say, and double ha. Ha ha. It's like you said, puppy love. Here, Kara. I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
Gomez.
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman like you were. Are. Like you are. She could even fall in love and get married like you did.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Of course, I didn't even think of that.
Besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have no reason to say this, what if she did meet someone who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar shingles.
No, no.
I think Wednesday and I should have a little chat.
Like a bull in the ring, like the moderate right wing, I'm trapped. Like a fly in my tea, or the New York DMV, I'm trapped. With my wife to my left, and my daughter to my right, any thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I could choose, sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a boat in a lock, or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground, or like Peter in the round, I'm trapped. I could cry, I could lie, I could simply up and die, but I fear the dice I've rolled have finally cracked. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cage? How trapped, trapped, trapped. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She stokes the Addams fire, she harbors each desire. I'd never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero instead of sniveling and weak? I'll pick her out, that's true, show me what I must do. Should I gripe, should I groan, would I rather pass a stone? Trapped, wife gone wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong and we'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to bail, show my coffin to the nail. If I napped, if I snapped, maybe dinner would be scrapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Trapped.
Wednesday and Lucas sitting in a tree. K-I-L-L-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes... That was intense! Do it again, do it again!
This dinner has to go okay.
It will if you let me blow up this Lucas guy.
Oh, Pugsley! Ever since I met him, I just want to laugh and cry and everything seems right and wrong at the same time. And then sometimes I just want to rip his flesh off and eat him up until there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled, and I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction, and I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do? Pulled.
Wow, you have got some serious issues.
Fly away, little birdie. Mother always said be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present danger when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction. And I think I like it.
That was good, that was good.
I think I like it.
Do it again, do it again.
I'm being pulled in a new direction. And this feeling I know is impossible. So I'll confide that I tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Pulled, pulled, pulled. Puppy dogs with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies at picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow fights, and Christmas Eve, sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets, and afternoon banana splits, angels watching as I sleep, Liberace's greatest hits have got me pulled in a new direction. If they keep insisting,
pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark and not obey every spark. Boy has a bite better far than his bark, and you'll meddle by two. Do what's truly taboo. As I pulled in a new direction.
I was right. It is the boy.
Yes, but maybe it's not such a big...
Puppy dogs, Disney World, she's in no state to entertain the guests. We have to cancel dinner.
No.
What?
I mean, we can't cancel the dinner.
Why?
Because then there wouldn't be any dinner.
Gomez, do you love your daughter? Do you care for her mental well-being?
Of course.
Do you want her to be put on heavy medication and spend the rest of her days hating us because we let her ruin her life?
There are four things...
Gomez! Would you stop that?
I think we should have this dinner.
Why?
We need to introduce her to the real world.
Are you out of your mind? Have you seen the world lately? Now stop prattling and go tell her the dinner is off.
But, Kara...
You're the father is the canceller. And if after 25 years of marriage you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Okay, family meeting. About tonight. Now, here's the schedule. First, we'll have drinks like, hi, nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Okay. Then, they'll want to see the house. We'll have dinner at 8, and they can be back to their hotel by 9:30.
Wednesday, your father has something he'd like to tell you.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I have had second thoughts.
What about?
This dinner, it all seems so quick.
It's not quick. Please, Daddy, it's just a dinner, and they're dying to meet you. And I promised Lucas, and you know how I hate to break a promise.
Yes, but your mother...
Daddy, please! I'm your only daughter and your eldest child, and if you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Maybe just a little dinner.
Thank you, Daddy.
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. So, dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Please, not the game.
But it's a family tradition.
But it's my dinner.
But it's my house, darling. Dinner and the game.
One out of two, Paloma. Don't push it.
Then can we at least all act normal?
Define normal.
Normal is an illusion, darling. What's normal for the spider is a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please. They're normal people, not like you, not like me. Please, can't we be an average family? One normal night, that's all I want, that's all I need from you. One normal house without a mouse to feed a plant or two. You must admit we're not what people call laid back. So can't we muse a bit and lose the basic black? Whoa, one normal night with normal people on their way. Just one normal night. What do you say?
One normal night.
Be polite to do the least you can.
One normal eve.
Can you achieve a kind of common man? You have to swear to me, yes, promise to the core. It's almost 6 o'clock, they're almost at the door. On all the Addams ancestors who've ever walked around. One normal night.
Okay, Lucas. Enough's enough. Give me the map.
I don't see any houses.
That's because there aren't any, Alice. We're in the middle of some godforsaken park.
Central Park, dear. Designed in 1857 by...
Wait!
What?
I know where we are. This is where I first saw her. I was lost in the park and a pigeon dropped my feet with an arrow in it. And I looked up and there she was. Wednesday, with a crossbow.
A what?
A crossbow, you know.
This girl carries around a crossbow.
Don't worry, Dad, she has a permit.
Good, good choice, son. Now here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna go back to the hotel, and you and me are gonna have a little talk.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
See what you did? Your mother's rhyming again. I say we go back to the hotel, and then...
No! We are not going back to the hotel. One normal night, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine. Tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food. Whoa, whoa, one normal night. I know it's big, but can't you see? This one normal night is for me. Come on.
Come on.
Seems like a nice young man.
But they're not right for each other.
What do you mean they're not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the sock vaccine? Was rehab right for Charlie Sheen? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trip. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain. But this is their moment and this is your chance. So if you don't want to remain, start singing of love.
What?
Love.
No.
Love.
Why?
Love.
Yeah.
Holy affairs of the heart. Oh, look, the choice is yours. Either you help these kids or you're stuck here for eternity. So?
We'll help them love.
Yes!
Love.
Right!
Love.
Good!
Love.
Yes!
Love lifts our spirits apart.
You got it. So, let the normalcy start.
Folks, act and rally round. Let's save them and the bad.
Hello. Had a little trouble finding the place. Looks like somebody shot out all your street lamps. Wow. Look at this place. Are you just moving or what?
No. This is how they live in New York. They spend all their money on rent and have nothing left for furniture.
Melbourne key. This is my wife, Alice. That is my son, Lucas. And you are? Nice talking to you. Earth to Alice? We've landed in Weird City. I say drinks and bye-bye.
Oh, Mal. Be open to experience and welcome in the new. Reach deep in your surprise bag. There might be a gift for you.
My surprise bag is so full, I can hardly lift it. That guy who patted me down at the airport, he slipped me his telephone number. I don't think I can stand any more surprises.
Come on, Dad. Lighten up. These are your kind of people. Real salt of the earth.
Yeah. Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715, the great Spanish warship, the Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Redondo Ventana Laguna Don Jose Cuervo, leaves Madrid, bound for the New World. 3 weeks later, he is still in Madrid, as Madrid is over 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man, he sets sail anyway, only to sink 6 months later off the southern coast of Florida, a hostile land inhabited by mosquitoes, rattlesnakes, and many retired Jewish people. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume, and the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke, and you must be young Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son, with the massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No matter, the night. She is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez Florencia Addams, at your service. And now, allow me to present my wife, La Duena, mother of my children, el amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia.
Sorry I'm late. I was putting an apple pie on the windowsill to cool.
And that's my little woman. A duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez.
And a gymnast in the bedroom.
Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Addams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
Alice, and you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I'm named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own leg.
They don't need to know that.
No, it's a beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his tongue. He talked like this. Hello, how are you?
Thank you, Mother.
Hi, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress?
A yellow dress.
Paloma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Will you excuse us for a moment? I won't have that color in my house.
I'm just being normal, okay?
We don't wear bright colors, darling. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination. Oh, look! It's everywhere!
It's a lovely dress, Wednesday.
Yellow is the color of the warming sun! Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun! Why
excellent. A lovely sentiment about the color yellow. And now, why look, everyone, it's Pugsley Addams, Wednesday's younger brother, just returned from Bible study. Say hello, Puggles.
Hello. Want to make a donation?
Of course, sweetheart. What are you saving up for?
Put the money in the can and no one gets hurt. Woo, boy, is it normal out there?
This is little Grandma Addams, the very heart and soul of the family.
Hi, just came back from the hospital, cardiac ward. Boy, they're dropping like flies over there. I hope you're staying in shape. Fresh fruit, grains, 40 minutes on the treadmill.
I know I should, but I don't do any of that.
Then you're gonna die, honey.
Are you ready for some football? Fester's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that sunbitch go. He's on the 20. He's rounding third and touchdown. The crowd goes wild. Yeah, Fester, you're so amazing.
This is my brother, Fester.
Good to meet you.
Thank you, Fester. All right, go away now.
Goodbye.
And now, a welcoming toast from the extensive Addams Caves.
Children, you're excused. Let's go, Lucas. Dad, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma.
Leave the door open. You hear?
Ah, you're concerned they will make the beast, huh? Not to worry, my friend. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. If he tries anything at all, she'll rip his throat out! To the children.
Excuse me, but do you have a little girl's room?
We used to. But we let them all go.
Gomez, come with me, dear. I'll show you.
Morticia, a grand tour for the missus. And the mister and I will go below for some guy stuff. And then after that, dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
Oh, yeah? What kind of game?
You ever play, charades?
Sure.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Did you get the flowers?
Oh, yes, and the lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it!
No!
When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem will get it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time, they just pop out and always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing that everybody needs and so little have.
Healthcare?
Oh, I love, of course!
Let's not talk about anything else but love. Worth repeating, let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, faltering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else.
They're going to freak when we tell them.
My father won't.
Why not?
I already told him.
What? You already told your father? Your father with the sword? You told him we're getting married just like that?
He's totally cool with it. Mostly.
I thought we were going to tell them all together.
You don't understand my mother. She could really screw this up. We need his help.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look, it might seem old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Then leave it to me. It's all going according to plan.
What plan? There is no plan.
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep him guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's just a simple dinner. What could go wrong? Come on.
Aw? Be patient, and soon the way will be clear. Focus your fear, and troubles all will disappear. Let's not talk about anything old.
Please don't leave us out in the cold.
Let's not talk about anything else but love.
But love.
But love.
Interesting chair. Antique?
15th century, the heretic's chair. Once owned by Thomas de Torquemada, Grand Inquisitor of Madrid.
So you collect this stuff?
A man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, others play golf. Me? I collect instruments of persuasion. Why, you ask? Go on, ask. Ask!
Why?
It's fun! The history of the world told in agony and dismemberment. Get up, I show you. So, you sit, and they ask you a question, and they get an answer that they don't like, and... Ooh! That'll make you believe, huh? Here, sit down. Let me ask you a question.
Some other time.
Okie dokie. So... How about these crazy kids, huh?
What about them?
They seem very fond of each other, do they not?
I guess, but it's not like they're getting married.
What, married? No, no. They do marry young these days, though, do they not?
I don't know what they do.
Then speak about you, the Beinecke saga. Your lives, your hopes, your dreams. Your son.
Lucas, he's a little soft, like his mother. But when he grows up, I'll toughen him up. Make him a real man.
Can I say something? You and I feel we understand each other. Do you feel this?
No. So tell me, Addams. 10,000 square feet, right in the middle of a public park. How'd you swing this place?
These 2 acres have been in my family ever since Queen Isabella of Spain deeded it to my great ancestor, Alfonso the Enormous, for services rendered.
What services?
Alfonso the Enormous. The Enormous? Do I need to draw you a diagram?
Oh.
Come by, Nikki. I show you the moat. Did you bring a bathing suit? Never mind, let's be crazy.
And this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who's that looking over her shoulder?
Oh no, that's her other head.
She has 2 heads?
Well, you know what they say.
And who's that man in the dress?
Oh, that's Aunt Herman, Wednesday's uncle, twice removed.
I don't understand.
Well, they removed it once, but it grew back. And this is Gomez and me on our wedding day.
What's that?
Our wedding vows.
That's so romantic. We promise to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promise to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
And you're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, it sure doesn't work that way in our house.
Well, how does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is a nice quiet goose. If I told him all my secrets, all hell would break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked.
What kind of marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Secrets are the enemies of passion. Speaking true will get you through the day. Truth is not a thing that one should ration, but I think you think of it that way. Never keep a sin inside the closet. Always give the facts a fighting chance. Every time you do, it's a deposit in the long-term life of your romance. Keep no secrets if you want them to remain your lover. Share all secrets. There's a world of things you might discover. Truth is beauty. He should always know exactly who you are. Bear your secrets, and your marriage will be healthier by far. Gomez adores me, never ignores me, always has put me first. And Alice, if he should try once telling a lie once, I'd throw him out head first. Kneeling, he'd plead I'd reconsider. Reeling, he'd quickly start to drown. Begging me for lenience, but at my first convenience, I'd put him on the first bus out of town.
Morticia, is Gomez truly devoted? Never misquoted, always the paragon.
Without a doubt.
And if you told you a lie, you'd whisper goodbye and leave him to carry on.
That's it exactly.
Is there no room for some discussion?
If Gomez lies,
is there no chance you might forgive?
A lie, and lies can kill. And life can quickly go downhill. She kept a secret and she wound up on the guillotine.
Now I see what you mean.
She kept a secret and they shot her with an M16.
That's not a pretty scene.
She kept a secret and she wound up on the cover of a magazine. She's quite the Philistine.
What's that one?
The dance routine. Keep a secret in his life.
So, where does a student get the money for an engagement ring?
Well, after schools, I work at the bookstore. And on weekends, I tutor kids for a charter school. And during the summers, I work in my uncle's grocery store.
Is any of that true?
Most of it.
And in your time off, wise guy?
Well, mostly I think about Wednesday and how much I love her and how we could have a wonderful life together.
And what does a Lucas Beinecke become when it grows up?
A writer, or maybe a medical examiner.
A medical examiner? Why?
You get to look at the inside of people's bodies and they don't care because they're dead.
Where'd you find this guy?
We found each other. It's kind of a miracle.
Gomez! Oh my God, Daddy.
What are we gonna do?
Let's just tell her it'll all be okay.
You said to wait for after dinner,
yes,
please.
Yes, I know.
Please,
I know.
Daddy.
What's for dinner?
I don't know, but we can't.
What
right
were
now.
The three of you talking about?
The weather.
The news.
The economy.
The economy.
We're gonna go now. See you at dinner.
Come, Lucas, I show you the moat. You ever seen a rat as big as a dachshund?
No, sir.
Gomez, what's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking. That was conspiring.
No, conspiring is, what are we going to do? Oh, we can't tell her yet. You said after dinner. What's for dinner?
That's what you were doing.
Kirita, stop this foolishness.
You're keeping something from me.
Kirita, I have never kept anything from you, and may lightning strike me down where I stand if I am.
That it should come to this.
Here, Kara. I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
No, Gomez.
What?
Not today.
But you've never turned down a trip to heaven.
Not today. I'll be in my room until you're ready to share, like a proper husband.
Morticia, Mia! Like a bug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man growing gray when his wife says not today. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Who could conceive it? What if I and one tiny lie started civil war? What if a line's been crossed, vows of commitment lost? How is that possible? Could that be possible?
The ring on, just for a minute.
After dinner.
But what if they hate each other?
What if they don't? Be like me, look on the bright side.
You make me so crazy.
Maybe you two should get
Huxley,
a room.
Stop sneaking around like that.
It's my house too, you know.
Excuse me while I kill my brother.
Let me handle this. Hey, it's the Pugster. What up, little man?
You trying to be cool?
Uh-huh.
'Cause you're not cool.
Your sister thinks I am.
She'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
I'm under a lot of stress. My sister is having an identity crisis.
We're gonna go now.
Can I come?
Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye.
But wait! Wait! What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? Why would she be so cruel? I could stab my arm myself, could rip my tonsils out, could set my hair aflame. I could spray my eyes with mace, but face the fact, without her, it wouldn't be the same.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You all about us can't deny. When a girl walks in with anybody wasting a wrong thing on her face,
hey,
she
gets Grandma.
Oh, hey, Stub. How's life?
Too long.
Tell me about it.
Hold on. What are you doing?
Restocking. Grandma's private stash. Herbs, potions, remedies, nature's candy. No prescription needed.
What's this one?
Peyote.
What's it do?
Makes you run around naked in the woods.
What about this one?
Buku leaf. You got someone giving you a hard time.
Maybe.
Sprinkle a little of this on his toast, and an hour later, he's in a padded room yelling, I'm Spartacus!
Grandma, what if there was this girl who met this guy, and he's all like, hey, it's the Pugster, what's up, little man? And she's all like, golly, and we're gonna go now, and they're running away together. What would you give her?
Nothing. She's your sister. Be happy for her.
But what if she doesn't get rid of him? What if all the good times are already behind me?
That's life, kid. You lose the things you love.
What's this one?
Acrimonium! You want to stay away from this baby.
Why?
Takes the lid off the id. Brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
I mean one swig of this, and Mary Poppins turns into Medea.
I don't understand your references.
Well, stop the damn texting and pick up a book once in a while. Now quit whining about your sister. You need to start thinking about you and how you're gonna live your life. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and fan little fairy wings. Now stay out of my shit or I'll rip your leg off and bury it in the backyard.
I love you.
Wednesday will drink and then she'll be herself again. Lucas will leave her be so she can torture me just like she always did. Till then, I'm just a strange fat kid.
Another magnificent feast. All thanks to my fabulous lady wife, from whom I keep nothing. This dinner puts me in mind of my great ancestor, Hector Fernando Escondido Chimichanga. A man hated by the church, but always quick with a quip. In fact, while he was being burned alive, he said to the priest, "Keep it pink in the middle, and a little crispy on the outside."
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please, not the game. It's getting late.
But it's a family tradition.
Pugsley, can you just go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will.
Carl, maybe the game's a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, someone will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
Oh, actually, the game's a good idea. The best of all ideas.
What kind of game?
We call it Obligación de Revelar.
Oh, Spanish! What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Everyone sips from the sacred chalice.
And confesses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you absolutely have to tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Sure you would.
Oh, no.
And Gomez will break the ice. My husband has something he needs to disclose.
No. The host goes last.
Lurch the chalice.
This is the sacred chalice from Addams' family's past. Firm in my teacher talis, held fast. Die cast. Here in the sweet libation, salvation presides. Feel the sweet sensation revelation provides. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people. Full disclosure, it's a hell of a thing. Once a favorite of the late day shopping. Doesn't matter if you're right or left wing. He loved his full disclosure.
Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure. Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure.
Yes, well, my disclosure is in the form of a fairy tale. Once upon a time, there was a man who had a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, and yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the ground she walked on. Thank you. And one day a fox appeared and gave the man a box of rare wooden Spanish leather. What's in the box? Asked the kindly man. Nothing important, a little secret, but you must never open it. So the man took it home to his wife, and she said, let's open it anyway. And the kindly man said, don't push it, honey, we've got a good thing going. And they never did open it, and they lived happily ever after. Full disclosure.
Well, we'll just have to come back to you, won't we? Wednesday's turn, pass.
Yes, let's hear from Fester. The chalice.
I am in love.
Aww.
Now, you might be thinking, what could a fat, bald person of no specific sexuality know about love? But I, too, am in love. Fester loves.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon.
The moon. He's in love with the moon.
Yeah, that's normal.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard!
Oh, I haven't told her yet.
Aww.
Full disclosure.
Full disclosure.
Just embrace it and swoon.
Embrace and swoon.
All from grace or fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon.
Close your sermon with a signature tune.
And call it full disclosure.
Wednesday's turn.
No.
Me. Ace before beauty, the chalice. The kid and I had a little heart to heart. I told him to use his time wisely. Look who's talking. How much have I got left? I'm 102. I've got shingles and arthritis. And when I break wind, it could start the windmills on an old Dutch painting. But I still got one round left in me. Call me cougar, but 5 will get you 10. There's a couple of 90-year-old hotties out there waiting to chow down on a grandma sandwich. Full disclosure. I just peed.
We should have put you down years ago. Wednesday's turn.
Not yet. Daddy, talk to her.
I've still got the fox box problem.
Wednesday, your turn. The chalice, please. Where's the chalice?
Yes! Now with a dash of potion, my sister blows her cool. Hopefully in slow motion, she'll drool. One sip of acrimonium, and then she will change. Boy, oh boy, her full disclosure's gonna be strange.
Full disclosure,
it's the moment of truth.
La, 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 la.
Now you better hit the truth like Babe Ruth.
La, 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 la.
This is torture like an impacted tooth.
Hooray for full.
As you can see, my wife isn't herself, so we'll be on our way.
No! We are in the middle of a game, so bite your lip and say your ass down!
Alice, I think you've had enough to
drink. Remember how it used to be, Mel? How we'd look at each other and leave the restaurant in the middle of dinner and rush home and go upstairs. And sometimes you couldn't even wait, so you just pull the car over to the
Mom!
Light up, Lucas! Parents, do it!
Grateful Dead t-shirts. Is he ever coming back? How long do I have to wait? A woman waits for marriage. A woman waits for children. She waits for her big Mal to come back home. At 5 o'clock, or 6 o'clock, till it's 9 o'clock, and there's no o'clock to ease the pain, pain she can't explain. As the woman waits in the dark for a spark that once was there, that isn't there.
Each other. Let's give it a shot. But you people are insane. You have a house where there shouldn't be a house. A zombie for a butler. And a man who is dating the moon.
Oh, I wouldn't exactly say we're dating.
We're simple people, Mr. Addams. We're not used to your sophisticated New York lifestyle. So with your permission, we're gonna head back to the real America. Full disclosure. Lucas, help your mother off the table.
You were right, Lucas.
Right about what?
Thanks anyway, Daddy.
Thanks for what?
We should have just told her.
Told me what?
It doesn't matter. Lucas and I love each other, and we're getting married.
What?
That's what you kept from me?
No secrets, huh?
Ha ha ha!
Yes, we kept a secret, and you kept it from me.
So we're getting married.
Aren't they getting married?
Really married, married, married. Full disclosure, what a miserable game. Play it once and life is never the same. Someone started it, so someone's to blame. Enough of fools.
You let nature take its course. Chaos. I mean, is this really any way to end an act? Actually, yes. But it'd be better if our guests couldn't leave just yet, don't you think?
Yeah!
All right, dead people, give me some weather.
It's a tornado! We'll never make it out of the park alive.
Well, by the keys, it looks like you'll be spending the night. That's what happens when you play.
Full disclosure.
Thank you.
Wait. We have to talk this over for a minute.
Talk what over?
We can't just run away and get married. You said that it was important that everyone got along.
And you said it didn't matter.
Yeah, but they want to kill each other. You want that hanging over our heads?
Boy, you sound just like your father. The root doesn't fall far from the tree, does it?
What?
Forget it.
The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
You're annoying.
You know what I think? You don't actually want to get married. You just said that to stick it to your mother.
Don't psychoanalyze me, Lucas. It's a deep, dark hole, and you don't want to go there. Come on.
What are we going to do for money?
Stop being so afraid of everything.
Yeah!
Right, like you're not scared.
I eat scared for breakfast.
Yeah!
Look, let's just go back inside the house and make some rational decisions.
No!
I don't want rational decisions. I want dangerous, impulsive, crazy decisions.
Yeah!
Are you coming or not?
Look, I can't run away like this. It's too crazy. I'm sorry.
Not as sorry as you're gonna be when you wake up and you're 46 and working for your father.
Wait, I can be impulsive. I just need to think about it first.
There you are. Secrets exposed. Marriages threatened. Delicious anarchy. So what happens next? Can this be repaired? Or do you all leave in an hour feeling vaguely depressed? Let's find out, shall we?
Humiliated, shamed, mortified.
Kara.
I told that Bonnie woman we kept nothing from each other.
My sweet, my only. Wednesday wasn't sure about the boy and I didn't want to worry you.
Oh, so you didn't dare tell me because I'm such a terrible mother.
You're a wonderful mother.
And look at the thanks I get. I gave up my dreams for the sake of this family. I wanted to travel. I wanted to see Paris. I never got to see the sewers of Paris. And now it'll never happen.
Kara.
So that's how it ends, alone and forgotten, in this tiny room, living on broken dreams and cat food. That's what happens to mothers. Look at yours. She came for the weekend, the weeks turn into months. It's 12 years later. She's still up there, deceived, deluded, smoking weed in the attic. A grandma. Well, I'm not going to end up like your mother.
My mother? I thought she was your mother. No, seriously.
You lied to me. I can't live with that.
Here, Kara. I feel the urge to take you in my arms.
Not today.
But Kara.
Out! My daughter's getting married. I can't believe it's true. She doesn't ask her mother before she says I do. And how about my husband and constant naive? This evening's getting serious, these Ohioans won't leave. But I can't let these latest troubles rob me of my bliss. For when I'm scared of true disaster, I remember this. Death is just around the corner, waiting patiently to strike. One unplanned electrocution, that's the kind of end I can comprehend. When I'm feeling uninspired, or I need a little spree, I'm reborn knowing death is just around the corner coming after me. Corner, get it? Death is just around the corner. Death is just around the corner, waiting high upon the hill. Someone buried in an avalanche, that's the
kind of gig I can really dig. Marriage often disappoints you. Not each husband is a gem. So all more knowing death is just around the corner coming after them. If life's a plum, I'll muddle through some. But when death comes, I hope it's gruesome. Ha-cha! Some people die from public stoning, faulty wiring, faulty zoning, cherry pits they didn't know were there. It could be by a jungle cat, perhaps an unsuccessful love affair. It could be on a speeding train, it could be underwater, it could be too much Novocaine, or even by your daughter. My darlings, it might even be tonight. Death is just around the corner. No one's ever been immune. Turning off a respirator with a simple click, scandalously quick. I can face a new tomorrow if I make it past today. I feel good saying death is just around the corner, swiftly on its way.
I feel so dark, I feel so dead, all is black inside my face.
Boy, they really got to you. That doesn't even rhyme.
You got a problem with that?
I did not raise my son to be kidnapped by a bunch of left-wing Spanish weirdos.
You didn't raise him now, I did. You were at the office, remember?
I was at the office for him, for you. I had plans for the boy.
Oh, Mal.
Follow his heart. That's crazy.
What's wrong with crazy? Crazy is underrated.
Let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, wants to marry someone named after a day of the week and runs around Central Park with a crossbow. And you're okay with all that?
If it makes him happy, yes.
Well, you better come to your senses, or I'm gonna have to take steps.
Good idea. How about you start by taking steps outside?
What?
You want to act like a tool? Go sleep in the shed! Ah! No!
What?
Oh, nothing.
storms past. Think I'll get a little moon. Ladies, hello. Yoo-hoo! Where are you hiding? Are you playing with me, my only one? Ah, there you are. Look at her. Lovely, is she not? And so far away. Yes, in matters of love, my dears, distance is our friend. Closeness, no thank you. A quarter of a million miles away, that's a good distance for romance. We never fight. Each waiting is a heartbreaking separation. Aww. Each meeting, a happy reunion. Aww. When the daylight ends and the moon ascends, I would rather be just the moon and me. When I feel her pull, then my heart is full, and the night is softly, sweetly calling. Fester, look and see. La 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true when the moon says I love you. Though I'm told it's wrong when I sing my song, she accepts, she attends, she believes, she befriends. La 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true when the moon says I love you. How it can feel when love is real.
Thank you.
Wednesday.
Don't even.
Where do you think you're going, young lady?
Away.
Elopement?
Daddy, will you please just let me go?
No! This is what comes from keeping secrets. If the two of you wanted to get married...
There's not gonna be any marriage.
No. Why?
He bailed.
What? A breach of promise? An outrage!
He thought running away was a bad idea.
On the other hand, he does have a good point.
I hate him.
That's a beginning. Something to build on.
He says he can't live without me, and then he lets me go. I love him. Why doesn't he love me?
You just said you hated him. Which is it?
Both.
Now you've got it. Right and wrong, who's to say which we should refuse? All we know, love survives either way we choose. Here you are at the edge, go ahead and fall. Don't resist, I insist, love still conquers all. And even conquer you, my adorable little Avila. You have to go and grow up.
And you're cool with that?
Yes. And no. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling sad. A little childish. A little dad. I think of all the days you've known. All the ways you've grown. See you on your own. And then I'm feeling happy and sad again. I think I'm rested, but then I'm tired. Do they request it? Tomorrow fired. And now a voice as he adores. She who once was yours. How can I ignore such news? I'm sad and happy. Why should I choose? Life is full of contradictions. Every inch a mile. At the moment we start weeping, that's when we should smile. So many memories. Wednesday eating her first worm. Wednesday sealing up her baby brother in the wall. Wednesday setting fire to that Jehovah's Witness. I look back and I think, where did the time go? And I am sad. But then, I see this beautiful young woman in front of me. And I am happy. Happy, sad. Happy, sad. Like a bull, when the Mendador stick his sword into him, and he say, nice job. I hate you. In every heaven, you'll find some hell. And there's a welcome in each farewell. Life can be harsh, the future strict. Who would dare predict? And the boy you picked, not bad. So let's be happy, completely happy, forever happy. And a tiny bit sad.
Thank you.
How long have we been standing in the shadows?
My whole life. Wow. You should be a writer. Have you met my daughter Wednesday? She's the best thing that will ever happen to you. Don't screw it up.
Yes?
Look, I can't stand the idea of being without you.
Well, 5 minutes ago you could.
No, but the lover always comes back. Tristan, Ulysses, Romeo.
Listen, I'm homeschooled. What's your point?
I'd rather die than live without you.
Okay. Prove it.
What?
Here.
Where'd you get...
Take that apple, put it on your head, and go stand against the tree.
Wait, you're gonna...
Uh-huh.
You're really crazy.
And you're not crazy enough. That's the problem. Aren't you afraid?
No. You know why? Because I'll guide the arrow. I'll guide it with my love.
How does that work exactly?
See, we have a connection. We're destined to be together, so nothing bad can happen.
Yeah? But what if I miss?
Then you'll be the last thing I ever see.
That is so hot.
Ready? Gotcha. Now will you marry me?
Yes, Lewis. 1,000 times yes.
Lucas. Lucas.
Gotcha.
Did you hear that? The boy was willing to die for love. Hard to believe he's your son.
He was so happy.
Do you remember that? Being happy?
Yeah. What happened?
Well, you turned into an unfeeling, rigid, selfish control freak.
Lester, you're a wise person. How can I fix this? What do I do?
Don't worry. It'll come to you.
I wasn't always this way. I was happy-go-lucky once. I told jokes, played the guitar, and slept in until noon. Then you get a wife and a kid, a mortgage.
Keep going.
But what do I say?
Just remember how you felt the first time you saw her.
Alice, it's Mal.
I know.
No, the old Mal.
The old Mal with the guitar and the t-shirt.
And the headband.
You were pretty crazy back then, you know that?
Yeah, I know. I guess I got stuck, Alice. More than most men. But Mom, I swear, I'll be crazy again.
Wow, you're rhyming!
For you, baby. Just for you. I learned from Lucas. I learned from you. I wasn't happy. I wasn't true. But then the way you spoke at dinner touched my soul. Completely crazy, yet completely in control. So when you kicked me out, I said, let's rock and roll. So I'll be crazier than you, much crazier than you. It warms me up to see you living large. When I'm crazier than you, far crazier than you, I'll drop the plan, you'll be the man in charge.
All the time and all I needed was the hope that you'd submit.
Too afraid and too conceited to believe that you were it. But the journey's now completed.
I miss your pumpkin, come to mama.
I want to treasure you in death as well as life. I want to cut you with my love and with my knife.
What's wrong, my little cockroach?
I can't sleep.
Why not?
There's no monster in my closet.
I'm sure he's hiding someplace else.
Mommy, I have a full disclosure.
Yes?
What if you tried doing something to somebody but ended up doing it to somebody else?
Are we talking about anyone we know?
Well, I was talking to Grandma.
Don't listen to that ancient woman. She may not even be a part of this family.
Is Wednesday really gonna marry that guy?
She might.
Oh no! Make me feel better, Mommy.
Life is a tightrope, my child. At the other end is your coffin. Better?
Uh-huh. Thanks, Mommy.
Now close your eyes or the monster won't come out and eat you up. Pugsley. Pugsley. Sleep well, my little vermin. Your mommy's life has fallen apart and she needs to go away for a while. And years from now, when your marriage collapses and you wonder who set us all on this road to hell, you can thank your father. Look after my baby, will you? Keep him in harm's way.
One little secret, and she throws me out. What was I supposed to do? I was trapped. But my one, my only, I make it up to you. You want to see the world? Done. You want sewers? I'll show you sewers fit for a queen. Where is that hotel? Aha! Hotel name. Rue de Toilette. Condemned 6 times by the Board of Health. Not enough. Voila! Hotel Nosferatu. Rating -3 stars. No windows, no towels, no staff. Bingo! The worst hotel in Paris. Get them on the line, my friend. This is the final round. Hurry! Did I ever once expect this day would come? Did I ever once expect the worst? Did I ever dream that I could feel this way? Dios mio, no, this is the first. I'm a Latin man, and Latin men are smart. Everything we do is muy sincere. Leading with a sword as much as with a heart. Never did I once expect to hear. Not today, she spat it in my face. Not today, not even second base. Not today, the words I hear her say. Not today, not today, not today. I remember well the day she poisoned me. No one else had cared enough to try. How did she uncover all the joys in me? All the way she promised I would die. Every year that passes, I desire her more. Anyone who knows us will agree. She's my every fever, flu, and canker sore. She's my only hepatitis B. Not today, I'm dancing on my own. Not today, a dog without a bone. Not today, that rotten Rondelet. Not today, not today, not today. Is that my phone call to Paris? It's about time. Hello? Hotel Nosferatu? Listen, the future of my marriage is at stake. Can you confirm this is the worst hotel in Paris? Because I need to get your ghoulish guarantee. What would I pay if you could say you'd serve my petit déjeuner from an abandoned and condemned patisserie? I must be clear, don't want to circulate misnomers. You must have roaches in the bath at any cost. It says right here in the new guide I got from Bromhurst that even in July the pipes are thick with frost.
Gomez, Gomez, Mortis is leaving! What? She's at the gate with the valise! It's the end of the family!
The moment where I turn a little gray. Is this the moment where my marriage vows decay? Is this the moment where Morticia runs away? No! Not today! Not today! Not today! So it's true.
I can't live with a man who keeps secrets.
Oh, yeah? Well, even you kept a secret. Once.
Never.
And if you're wrong?
I never am.
But if you are, what will you give me?
Name it.
A dance.
Go on.
When we were young and in love and wanted to get married, we came to your father. And he said, wonderful, let's go tell your mother. And what did you say?
How could I possibly remember?
You said, no. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
That's different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, and loved nothing more than stirring up trouble.
Uh-huh.
Oh, God! I've turned into my mother!
And Wednesday is you. Isn't it wonderful?
You did that like a lawyer.
No. Just a husband. And a father. Not so easy. In fact, very difficult. Let's live before we die. Let's laugh before we cry. Let's hold each other tight and dance. If I have caused you pain. It's easy to explain. Come fill me with the light and dance. My love, my life, forever you will be. But when's this life that too is part of me? Two women I adore and swore to suffer for. Let's end this tug of war and dance.
Mother told me to beware of clever men with silver tongues.
What I lack in depth, I make up for in shallowness.
You think you can sway me with a joke?
Well, it is the last thing I tried before the chloroform.
Tomorrow I may be in rainy Gay Paris.
Please stay right where you are and dance.
I'm not a castanet who clicks with no regrets.
You're more than that by far, so dance.
The
place wherein can never be what was. Till we begin to do what dancing does. My darling, I was bad, bad husband and bad dad. Instead of being sad,
alone
we're lost, we're drifting out to sea.
But
side by side, we're gloomy as can be. As gloomy as can be. Morticia, I was wrong. I knew it all along. Forgive me with a song.
And dance.
Mi amor, creature of constant surprises, you have legs!
Ladies!
Thank you.
Addams.
You changed our lives.
How can we ever thank you?
Tell your friends. Word of mouth is important. Young lady, step forward and speak the words every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry. You really want to marry this boy?
I do.
Why?
He's willing to die for me.
Mother,
we have something to ask you.
Yes?
Go on, just ask her.
Can we have your blessing? Of course. May you have many children, and may they give you as much grief as you've given us.
Attention, everybody! I have a full disclosure. I'm taking my beautiful wife to Paris.
Oh, Gomez, the sewers.
Special package. One day, 7 nights.
Je t'aime, mon cher. Je t'aime toujours.
Ah, the French.
Okay, fun seekers. My acrimonium was missing, so I sniffed around. Tell them what happened, you little bedbug.
You're all so smart, you figure it out.
All right, so you were afraid you'd lose your sister.
So you stole my acrimonium.
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with each other.
But I never got to drink it because...
Because I passed it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And I reached deep into my reservoir of womanly compassion and bathed your father in forgiveness.
Welcome to the family. We're not losing a daughter. We're gaining 3 Beinekes. Young man, for purely selfish motives, you turn a simple dinner party into a night from hell.
We couldn't be more proud.
Pugsley, you're an artist. You rearranged life itself and it all came out even. You're the best brother in the world.
So you're still gonna torture me?
Of course. Until you find a girl of your own.
Young man, you reached deep into the darkness of your despair and became who you truly were. You are a true Addams.
I'm moving toward my darkness.
Au revoir, Fester. May you find your bliss. Excuse me, Fester, but where are you going?
To the moon, Alice.
Something old.
Something new.
Craziness writ large.
Someone bold.
Someone true.
Someone new.
I'm coming, my love. Stay full.
Fly, my lunatic brother.
Fly on wings of love!
First and best.